The AIM-9 Sidewinder, one of the most iconic air-to-air missiles ever built. Fast, deadly, and surprisingly old. First fired in the 1950s, this missile has evolved through dozens of versions, upgrades, and clones, flying on everything from F-4 Phantoms to modern F-35s. In this video, we'll go through every major Sidewinder variant in order, explain how each one improved on the last, and look at the international copies and spin-offs that made the Sidewinder the icon it is. Before we dive in, here is a quick explanation on how IR-guided missiles like the Sidewinder work. This type of missiles usually have an infrared seeker in their nose, which locks onto the heat signature of enemy aircraft, usually the engine exhaust. Once fired, the missile homes in on the heat, adjusting its flight path and using control fins. It's basically a very angry heat-seeking dart flying through the air with explosives. Simple, deadly, and usually hard to shake. Our story starts with the AIM-9A, the very first prototype Sidewinder. Developed by the US Navy in the early 1950s, the AIM-9A was an experimental missile designed to basically home in on the heat of an enemy aircraft's engine. It featured a rudimentary infrared seeker and control fins, but it was never actually intended for combat. Only a handful were built for testing purposes. It was a proof of concept that kickstarted the entire Sidewinder family. In 1956, the AIM-9B became the first Sidewinder variant to enter active service. This was the missile that truly changed air combat. It had a basic rear aspect infrared seeker, meaning it could only track the heat from the back of an enemy jet. Still, it worked, and it worked well enough to score kills in both the Korean War and Vietnam. Over 80,000 AIM-9Bs were produced. Compared to the A model, the B was operationally ready and refined for mass production. This version also gave birth to several copies. Sweden licensed it as the RB-24, Taiwan developed the TC-1, and China reverse-engineered it to create the PL-2. Next came the AIM-9C, an unusual detour. Unlike previous models, the C used the radar guidance instead of infrared. It was developed for the F-8 Crusader, aiming to give it a beyond visual range capability. While technically it did work, it didn't perform well enough to justify wide-scale use. Only a few hundred were made, and most were later converted into HGM-122 sidearm anti-radar missiles. It didn't improve on the B in combat effectiveness, but it was an interesting side project in missile evolution. The AIM-9D marked a major step forward. Introduced in the mid-1960s, this version featured a cooled infrared seeker, which dramatically improved its sensitivity and tracking range. It also had redesigned fins for better maneuverability and improved range over the B model. The D model returned to using an infrared seeker, but made it far more effective in real combat. This model was heavily used by the Navy during the Vietnam War and formed the backbone of the missile's evolution moving forward. While the Navy developed the D model, the Air Force opted to upgrade its stock of AIM-9Bs into a new version, the AIM-9E. It used a more modern seeker with better electronics, giving it slightly improved tracking and reliability. Although it wasn't as advanced as the D model, it was much cheaper, and it allowed the Air Force to field a large number of capable missiles without a complete redesign. A bit like taking your classic car and swapping out the engine. It gets the job done. The AIM-9F was a European-produced variant of the AIM-9B, manufactured under license by Germany. It featured improved reliability, more modern electronics, and a better seeker suited for European operational environments. Even though it's commonly associated with the E model due to timeline and deployment similarities, the F model actually retained more B-line features and was a part of a separate development track. This variant also became the basis for many NATO-aligned air forces during the Cold War. The Navy's answer to improving the D came in the form of the AIM-9G. It introduced a better guidance system and a larger control surface area for improved agility. This made the missile much more responsive and accurate, especially during fast maneuvers. It was more reliable and had a better kill probability than the D model. The AIM-9H was an evolution of the G model, primarily focused on improving reliability and maintenance. Internally, it had better electronics, more modular components, and was easier to service. It retained the performance of the G model, but made it more practical for sustained operations. Think of it as the Sidewinder that didn't need a mechanic after every flight. While the Navy had the G and the H, the Air Force developed the AIM-9J. It was essentially a modernized version of the older AIM-9E, with improved control systems, a better seeker, and upgraded electronics. This variant brought it closer in performance to the Navy's G model. It marked the beginning of trying to get everyone on the same missile page. The AIM-9N followed as an improved version of the J. It had more advanced seeker and better resistance to countermeasures, making it much more survivable in combat. Compared to the J, the N had better lock-on capabilities and was more effective against maneuvering targets. The AIM-9P was developed as a simplified and export-friendly version of the earlier models. It went through several sub-variants like the P1, P2, P3, and etc. Each was incremental improvements like better seekers and improved fuses. One of the most important variants was the AIM-9P-5, which finally introduced all aspect capability, a major upgrade for the export missile family. This missile was widely exported to countries like Pakistan, Egypt, and Turkey. The AIM-9L was a true game changer. Introduced in the late 1970s, it was the first Sidewinder that could engage targets from any angle, not just from behind. This all-aspect capability meant it could lock onto heat signatures from the front, side, or rear. It also featured improved electronics, better countermeasure resistance, and more lethal warheads. The L proved itself in combat, most notably during the Falklands War. You didn't need to be sneaky anymore, just hot enough to be noticed. One sub-variant, the AIM-9LI, acted as a transitional version with partial AIM-9M electronics before the full M model was introduced. Building on the L, the AIM-9M introduced better electronic countermeasures, or ECCM, improved guidance, and reduced smoke from the rocket motor, making it harder for enemies to spot the launch. It retained the all-aspect seeker of the L, but was much more survivable and reliable. The AIM-9X is the most advanced version to date. Introduced in the early 2000s, it features a high-resolution imaging infrared seeker, extreme maneuverability thanks to thrust vectoring, and helmet-mounted cueing systems that allow pilots to fire the missile by just looking at a target. Compared to the M, the X isn't just a step. It's a whole new generation. It's like upgrading from a console to a PC. You're still gaming, but the experience is totally different. Its latest evolution, the AIM-9X Block 2, adds full lock-on after-launch capability, enhanced data link features, and improved countermeasures, making it the most versatile and survivable Sidewinder ever built. The AIM-9's design was so influential that it inspired dozens of copies and licensed variants around the world. China reverse-engineered the AIM-9B to create the PL-2, later improving it into the PL-5 and PL-8. The Soviet Union captured a Sidewinder and used it to create the R-3 and R-13, known in NATO as the AA-2 Adol. Israel developed the Python series, starting from Sidewinder routes and evolving into missiles like the Python 4 and Python 5, among the most advanced short-range missiles today. Sweden produced licensed versions like the RB-24 and RB-74, while Taiwan built the TC-1. South Africa and Brazil co-developed the A-Darter, which incorporates AIM-9X and Python-style features. From a primitive prototype to a modern heat-seeking killer, the AIM-9 Sidewinder has grown and transformed more than any other missile in aerial combat history. Its design has stood the test of time, constantly adapting to new technology and new threats. It's been copied, upgraded, and launched from dozens of aircraft over the decades. While this video focused mostly on the major Sidewinder variants, there are also lesser-known versions like the AIM-9Q, R, and K, which were either limited upgrades, experimental models, or export designations. While they didn't change the missile's history as much, they're still a part of the larger Sidewinder family. If you like this missile breakdown and you would like to see more missile deep dives like this, let me know down in the comments. Thank you for watching, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.